Pete Elliott, U.S. Marshal for the Northern District of Ohio. I'm joined today by Chief Larry Reich of the Eastlake Police Department. Mayor Morley is up there, correct? I can't see behind these boards. Identifiers International, Dr. Colleen Fitzpatrick and Dr. Margaret Press. Cuyahoga County Medical Examiner's Office, Dr. Thomas Gilson and Dr. Butt. I have a number of U.S. Marshals interns here who worked on this case over the years, and some of my deputies are here. Many were just called out, and they are working on the 9-year-old girl that was shot and killed last night here in the city of Cleveland. You're going to hear more on that a little bit later. So today we're here to talk about one of Northeast Ohio's biggest mysteries that has now been solved, and that is the true identity of the person known as Joseph Newton Chandler III of Eastlake, Ohio. For those that do not know, Joseph Newton Chandler arrived in Northeast Ohio in 1978. After receiving a Social Security number in September of that year in Rapid City, South Dakota, at the age of 41. You can keep it there. Is that on that border right there? Okay. Joseph Newton Chandler began working at major Cleveland area companies as a draftsman and electrical engineer. He lived in our area from 1978 to his death in 2002. In July of 2002, Joseph Newton Chandler locked all the doors and windows in his apartment in Eastlake, Ohio, turned off the air conditioning, marked off the days of the week and month on his calendar, went into his bathroom, put a gun underneath the roof of his mouth, pulled the trigger, and committed suicide. It took about a week for Eastlake police to discover the body, which was badly decomposed. No fingerprints were attainable, and the body was eventually cremated. Chandler had left $82,000 in a bank account with no next of kin or family listed. At the time, it appeared as a typical suicide. Co-workers of Chandler described him as a loner, no family or friends, kept to himself, highly, highly intelligent, a builder of various electronic devices. You could see on that board some of the devices that he built. Very bizarre in his behavior, and that he used to leave the area of Eastlake for periods of time, stating they are getting close. Then he would return home days and sometimes weeks later. Co-workers thought he was just odd, isolated, and just an eccentric person. After the suicide, authorities attempted to locate the next of kin of Joseph Newton Chandler, and they discovered that the real Joseph Newton Chandler died in 1945, here on this board, in a traffic accident in Texas with both of his parents right before Christmas. Joseph Newton Chandler was 8 years old when he was killed while driving to his grandmother's house in Texas with a vehicle full of Christmas gifts. He was born March 11, 1937, and died in that accident on December 21st of 1945. Joseph Newton Chandler never had a chance to live his life, but someone else would come to live it for him. In 1978, the imposter had acquired a Social Security number in Chandler's name in Rapid City, South Dakota, using the real name of both Chandler's parents as well as the real Chandler's date of birth. Many investigators worked on the initial case and were stumped. In fact, two of them are back there right now. One is Tom Doyle, Eastlake Police, and my father, who was a private investigator on the case originally. The case went cold for many, many years. Many articles and books were written as to the possibility of the unknown story of his true identity. In 2014, at the request of the Eastlake Police Department, the United States Marshal Service for Northern Ohio adopted the case. Chandler was looked at originally for comparison to unsolved fugitive cases over the years in the 1960s and 1970s. We were able to identify that Chandler was hospitalized in the year 2000, 2 years before his death, for a medical procedure, and a tissue sample was taken for him at that time. We had that sample tested at the Cuyahoga County Medical Examiner's Office, who is here today, to obtain DNA for comparison. A DNA profile was uploaded into national databases and systems, but provided no comparisons of value. Enter Dr. Colleen Fitzpatrick and Dr. Margaret Press. In 2016, we contacted Dr. Colleen Fitzpatrick, president of Identifiers International, for assistance. The DNA profile from Chandler was sent to the lab in Cuyahoga County. Dr. Fitzpatrick and Press was sent to them for comparison in Y-DNA genetic databases. Dr. Fitzpatrick and Press were able to determine that Chandler's real last name was Nicholas, or a variation of Nicholas. This was the first investigation in Marshal Service history that we utilized forensic genealogy. In early 2018, Identifiers International, led by Dr. Colleen Fitzpatrick and Dr. Margaret Press, along with a team of investigators, were able to locate a Robert Ivan Nichols from New Albany, Indiana, if you can get board number four, who had similarities to Chandler. We then began an investigation to find relatives and find other information on Nichols. In March of 2018, the Marshal Service located a son of Nichols who resided in Ohio. We obtained DNA from him, which we then provided to the Cuyahoga County Medical Examiner's Office, who originally had the DNA of Chandler. That DNA sample from the Nichols son positively matched with the DNA of the person calling himself Joseph Newton Chandler III. The son stated to us that his last contact with his father was in 1965, when he received a letter from him, from his father, postmarked from Napa, California. We learned that Nichols was in the United States Navy, World War II, originally stationed in San Francisco, and served on the USS Aaron Ward, which was bombed by the Japanese on May 3rd of 1945. Nichols was injured and later received the Purple Heart. Nichols came back from the war and burned his uniforms, according to family members. Can you get board number five, please? Handwritten letters, postmarks, and documentation that we received shows that Nichols resided in Dearborn, Michigan in 1964, then settled in San Francisco and the Richmond, California areas in 1965, and possibly the Los Angeles area. He was reported missing in 1965 by his parents and his family, and numerous attempts by California authorities and Indiana authorities and authorities all over the U.S. failed to locate him and were unsuccessful. If you can get the next board, please. Sorry about all the boards. This thing's just really hard to explain at some point. So the family never heard from Nichols again after 1965. Now, the first part of this mystery of who Joseph Newton Chandler is has now been solved. But now we need the public's help to determine the why. There is a reason he went missing in 1965 and assumed the name of a deceased 8-year-old boy in 1978 and went hiding for so many years. There is a reason he never again contacted his family, left $82,000 in a bank account without leaving it to his own son, who resided in our state. Robert Ivan Nichols never wanted to be found throughout his lifetime, even into his death. And someone out there may hold the key as to why. Now, I think what I'll do first You know, with Father's Day this last Sunday, I know this was not the reunion that Philip Nichols envisioned for his father, his missing father many years ago, but hopefully this will bring some degree of closure to his family. And I first